You're on the air 970 WFLA.
Chickadee, chickadee.
You're on the air 970 WFLA.
I thought you said that you're going to stay on night show, Bob. You wasn't going to go back to daytime. You said it was in your contract that you promised that you would not go to day. Now you're saying now that you're going to switch to morning, Bob?
I'm saying whatever you heard.
No, Bob. Come on, Bob. What's the truth?
I'm saying whatever you heard.
For years you dreamed of being on nighttime radio. When you came back here to FLA, now you just told a caller that you're going to have a meeting and that you want to push it up to the daytime talk show?
No, that's not what I said at all. I said we're going to have a meeting to decide whether or not I continue to do both shows. It's going to cost them a lot of money if they want me to do both of them.
Okay, Bob. All right. Bye-bye.
Hi, you're on the air 970 WFLA.
Hello, Bob.
Yes.
I'd like to invite you to come with us tonight, my business partner, myself, and we'll stand guard at one of those black churches.
Well, sir, you can go stand guard at any black church you want to.
Basically, if you got one in particular you're interested in protecting, let us know. We'll be glad to sit over there and watch it.
Well, what does that mean, sir?
Well, that means that we do something about the church burnings instead of just wring our hands and raise hate and connections.
Well, sir, unfortunately, as far as you are concerned, I employ police to do that kind of work. It's very dangerous and very stupid for private citizens to get involved in that kind of stuff.
The police have no individual responsibility regarding individuals. That includes individuals' property.
And you have a responsibility for guarding other people's property.
I have a responsibility to my community to ensure that this sort of stuff stops.
Mm-hmm.
I'm giving you an opportunity to participate with us.
Oh, that's so sweet of you, sir. As a matter of fact, you could say that's very white of you. Let's go to this line. Whoops. Okay, be that way. You're on the air 970 WFLA.
Hello, Mr. Lassiter, or should I call you Maestro?
It's up to you.
Okay, Maestro.
Whichever you're most comfortable with.
Maestro would be nice. That's a new name for you. I think it's great what FLA did, putting you here. I mean, it's just cheesing off all the Rush Limbaugh, Mark Larson people that have no idea what they're doing, so they listen to Rush, and whatever he says or whatever Mark says, agree with it, and then try to argue with that. It's so easy to tear apart their arguments.
Yes, it is a public service. I'm really surprised that J-Corps really had that much feeling for the audience to want to straighten them out.
I think it's beautiful. I can't stand those people. I'm as liberal as they come. I don't think anybody should have a gun. I believe in health care, everything. So when people like me finally get, I don't know, it's just great.
Well, it's about time, too.
Man, this is good. So hopefully you're going to be here, and hopefully all the people that listen to Mark are just flipping out because they have no idea what to do.
No, they don't.
They have nobody to feed them their garbage.
Well, they could, they could go to the Rush Room. Oh, I think they all closed.
Those things. He is the worst.
Well, geez, if they hadn't all closed, I guess they could go there. Well, maybe they could open up new Mark Rooms or something,
Yeah. One thing to say for him.
Like down at the Morrisons.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Like the little guy in the Simpsons at Labs.
Uh-huh.
That's the best comeback for them.
Well, come on, join with me. Yeah, 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 yeah.
He's canceled.
Well, you take care, Maestro, and this is funny. I'm enjoying it.
Okay, dude.
Bye-bye.
Be good. You're on the air 970 WFLA. You're on the air 970 WFLA.
Mad Dog.
Yes, sir.
Even though you can orchestrate and play people very well, Maestro's a little bit stuffy, don't you think?
Do you think so?
A little bit.
What would you suggest?
I like Mad Dog. I like Magnificent Lassiter.
Oh, Magnificent Lassiter. The only reason... It actually makes me uncomfortable. The only reason I do it is because there are some people who actually believe that I mean it. And it really pisses them off. But it's so damn pretentious,
Well, Maestro...
But Maestro is a little pretentious, too.
It's a little stuffy. I'm a musician. I've played in orchestras. And I don't see you in tails and tucked with a baton.
Well, that's the way I'm dressed this morning, standing behind a conductor's stand here. I've got my little my little baton, and I'm tapping it, and they're doing whatever I tell them to do. They've been doing it all week.
But you can do that with trained... I have a schnauzer.
Yeah.
Very, very well trained, and I can do that with her.
Well, that's what I'm working with, schnauzers.
Okay. I don't know what's going on with Larson. I, I missed you from SUN and found you here last month at nights. And I haven't listened this week, except I just happened to accidentally find you today.
Well, it's my understanding that there will be some kind of an announcement, probably in the 1 o'clock hour, concerning precisely what's going on there.
Okay.
Okay?
Yes, sir.
Be
welcome,
good.
Welcome back and hang in there.
Okay.
No maestro.
Okay. It's 11:40.
You want me to on now? Okay, all right. News Radio 970 WFLA, it's 11:43. Brian James here. I'll take care of some business here first. Stop by Circle K at the corner of Little Road and Fox Hollow in Port Richey for prizes and pizza. I'll be there tomorrow from 2 until 4. I'm at as a loss for this thing as you are. Why am I here? I had a noon appointment, walking down the hallway, and suddenly I'm told to come in here and sit down and do the last few minutes of the program. So I'm going to continue just where Bob left off. Let me get the phones here. 970 WFLA.
Isn't Bob answering anymore?
Ma'am, they took Bob away. He's been pulled off the air.
Oh, gasp. Why?
I honestly don't know. I'm kind of at a loss for what's going on here, but...
Oh, well, okay. What I was calling about, maybe you can play him. There's a song called Lumberjack Song.
Uh-huh.
You ever heard it?
Yes.
Okay, can you play that?
Wow.
Oh, I know.
I could probably do that. I'll see if I can find it.
Ooh, thank you.
All right, thank you. All right. You're on the air, 970 WFLA.
Yeah, let me speak to Laster.
He's gone, sir. He's been pulled off the air.
No, he hasn't.
Yeah, he has.
This is him right here.
No, it's not, sir. This is Brian James.
No.
Yeah, it is.
This is Brian James?
If you're not smart enough to figure that, sir, go away. Hi, 970 WFLA.
What an improvement.
Well, thank you, but I've got, like, nothing prepared. I don't know what to do. What were you guys talking about?
I don't know. We were talking about nothing as far as I'm concerned.
Uh-huh.
For the last hour, I've listened to hang-ups, name-calling, you name it. It's been there. Everything but something with intelligence-based in it.
Mm-hmm.
And thank God you're here. I'm glad that there's somebody with a brain.
Well, I wouldn't go that far. I normally don't think well until the sun is nice and warm, long about 2 o'clock in the afternoon.
You know, Laster might be a nice guy on the outside and something like that, but as far as on the air, I mean, he's down to one brain cell and it's sputtering, I guess. I don't know.
Well, you're entitled to your opinion.
Well, I tell you what, it's a relief to talk about something besides things like and things like that.
Well,
hi,
yeah.
Brian.
How you doing?
Is it raining over there?
Look, I got boatloads of people on the phone here I need to get to,
well,
okay?
I'm glad you do. Go talk to them and have a nice day.
All right, man. Take care. Let me get 970 WFLA.
How you doing, Brian?
Good, sir.
You're the man. You're the man. I just want to ask you, is Lasseter gay?
No, sir.
He sounds like it.
I met his wife.
Really?
Yes, I have.
How much hair does she have on her face?
Oh, you're being mean.
Now, he's really bad, I tell you. But
why so? What are you so?
I think we need to have a diverse opinion. He needs to have it. We need to have a liberal on there so we can just see how wrong they are.
Well, what's been the whole hang-up here? I came in the door this morning. The phone lines are ringing. People are complaining.
Been going on for 3 days because he's been just been rude to everybody. You know, he's got his opinion and everybody's wrong, and he just, you know.
Aren't you used to that by now, though? That's just Bob.
Well, I don't know how the guy even got on radio in the first place. How did he even get a career in radio? It's amazing to me that the guy even has a job.
He was Marconi's board op.
I don't see how he can be making your radio station any money with the kind of attitude he's got. He's very rude to people. I mean, look, having your opinion is one thing, and having a liberal point of view is great. I think we need to have that on the air, but this guy is just really, he's gone beyond the bounds of being
so your main complaint is he's rude?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well,
right.
Not only rude, but he's just, he's got a chip on his shoulder.
I'm sure that management will pay attention to that. I appreciate it.
Thanks.
Take care. All right, let me get this one. 970 WFLA.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
I was listening to another caller who was cut off by Mr. Lasseter, who was trying to give some information.
And mm-hmm. Like, what did it sound like? Hi, who's this?
Hey, this is Mike, Brian. How you doing?
I'm doing well. What's up?
The DigiDoc. Hey, you guys, you're fantastic. I'm enjoying all of this. You guys are such great entertainers. I'm cracking up so bad I can't even drive the truck.
All right, good. 970 WFLA, what's up?
Can I talk to Bob?
Bob's not here, ma'am. He's been pulled off the air.
I'll talk to the other guy.
You're talking to him. Go ahead.
Oh, I was just going to babble. I just want to tell him that this is great. This is the most fun I've had in, at work in months. I hope they keep him.
All right. Well, have fun. All right. 970 WFLA. Hi, who's this?
Al.
We'll talk.
I have a question and a comment.
Well, ask.
What's the business number? The front office number?
839-9393.
839-9393.
Yes, sir. All right.
This is the best radio I've ever heard.
All right, good, sir. Appreciate it. Take care. All right. 970 WFLA.
Do the Lassiter sneeze.
All right. 970 WFLA.
Yeah, when's Larson coming back?
When's Larson coming back?
Yes, sir.
I have no idea, sir. All I've been told is that I was walking down the hall this morning, get in here and get behind the microphone. You got about 20 minutes to kill, so.
Well, did they kick Lassiter's big fat butt out?
He was taken out of the room, and that's the last I know of it. That's all I know at this point. How many? He's kind of a peaceable guy. He's not going to argue too much. I mean, he just walked out.
I'll be there. See ya.
All right. 970 WFLA.
Brian.
Yes, sir.
Hey, it's Andy in Tampa.
How are you, Andy?
Think you should do dog and cat recipes for the rest of the time.
Dog and cat recipes? No, I don't think so. 970 WFLA.
Hey, this is Don from Palm Harbor.
Hi, Don.
Has Mark Larson been replaced by Lassiter?
Sir, there are certain things in this business that I'm not allowed to comment on. I mean, I'm contractually obligated not to talk about the inside workings of the radio station because I have to kind of keep my mouth shut on certain issues.
No, I'm asking, has any formal announcement been made, or is Mark off for a week, or...
I think you'll probably find if I had to make a guess at this point, a major announcement forthcoming Monday.
Well, okay, can't think of a worse possible replacement for Larson than...
Well, sir, I'm really not allowed to comment at this
point.
That's
fine. That's good, because I've just decided to stop listening. I can't stand the man.
All right, I'll stop listening to you then. 970 WFLA.
Bob Lassiter, friend to the Negro.
All right. 970 WFLA.
Yes? Hello?
Yes?
It's a pleasure to hear a nice, soothing voice after that guy Larson.
Bite me. 970 WFLA.
Hey, Brain.
What's up?
I just want to make sure, before Lassiter leaves the building, somebody needs to make sure he has Al Gardner's phone number.
970 WFLA.
Hi, I want to talk to Brian a minute.
Speaking.
Brian, listen, I just to fill you in real quick, at the top of the show, this whole thing started today when Bob, in his monologue, opened by saying that anybody who didn't like the Clintons were probably trying to deny either the poor, the blacks, or the homosexuals a piece of America's pie. And then he went on to say, if you don't think there's a conspiracy to burn black churches that we need to talk about, then you're probably secretly happy that it's happening. I mean... And he couldn't think of any other reason for anybody to have any of those positions.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, everything went to hell in a handbasket from there.
Well, you know, I don't want to get into, like I said, I don't want to do any Lassiter bashing here, but at the same point, the man's kind of, when he takes a stand, he's, you know, it's hardline. There he is. So
I was waiting for the whole show for somebody to call up and, you know, just simply tell the guy in a matter-of-fact way that, you know, some of us don't like Clinton because we just don't like anybody else spending our money for us. We'd rather do it ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I don't want to live in a fiefdom. And that I'm waiting to see who's responsible for the fire burnings. Last I heard, there were two black guys arrested and a 14-year-old girl who I don't think were part of a conspiracy. But he won't listen to reasonable argument. He starts denigrating anybody who tries to make a point. And so the guy gets himself in all kind of trouble. You know, sounds to me like he wants to be a Neil Rogers.
Well, sir, I just, like I said, I don't want to get into sitting here spending time doing this, so we'll move along and get some phone calls answered. 970 WFLA.
Bob, God.
Well, there's a positive thought. 970 WFLA.
Brian, great show. I got a great lineup for you.
What's that?
Okay, the normal morning program that you have.
Mm-hmm.
Then in the afternoon instead of Rush. You know, I love entertainment radio. I can't wait to hear when you get on the air. Then let's put on Phil Henry. You know, he's leaving WIOD down in Miami.
Yeah.
He is terrific, all right? That would make your...
Are you a program director?
No, no, okay. Not all at
right. All right, well, I got to move along. We got a bunch of phone calls here. 970 WFLA.
Yeah, you know what WFLA needs? A good dose of Don and Mike.
All right, sir, have a nice day. 970 WFLA.
All right, how you doing?
Good.
I was just checking to see where Bob's at now.
Bob was removed from the air about 15 minutes ago.
Yeah, I know. I tried to call in, and the phone's been busy.
Well,
they are
quite busy, sir.
I'm unhappy that he's not on the air now.
Well, do yourself a favor and just kind of pick up the phone, dial the business lines, and voice that for me, okay?
Okay.
Take care. All right. 970 WFLA.
Brian.
Yes, sir.
Why don't you start doing the 9-to-9 shift?
9-to-9?
Yeah, we'll call it the Brian James Network.
I don't think so. Please. That's a little long. I'm happy with my little 3. That's all I want.
Very nice. Well, they can let everybody else leave and yank them. We want to keep you.
All right, appreciate it. Take care. All right, 970 WFLA.
Hey, Brian.
Yes, sir.
Hey, I'll tell you what, man. The radio this morning was great. You know, I can't believe they removed Lasseter from the air.
Well, you know, I honestly wish, and I'm going to plead ignorance in this case. I was just getting ready. I had some work to do this morning. I didn't have a chance to turn on the radio. I have no idea what was going on other than what I've gleaned off a couple of phone callers here. But it sounds like it was quite a little row going on.
Yeah, I'll tell you, you know, he may have sounded a little bit rude at some point, but, you know, I listen to him every night, and I listen to you, too, by the way.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I love both of your shows.
Thank you.
You know, it's just that people don't realize, you know, people want to call up, they want to call him asshole and all that other kind of stuff. But, you know, the guy, you know, he can be a great guy.
Mm-hmm.
And people just don't realize that.
No, I've had plenty of wonderful, nice, friendly conversations with Bob Lasseter. So I don't doubt that for a second, but I'd sure as hell like to know what went on this morning. So,
yeah, I mean,
anyway, got to move along.
Okay.
Take care. All right. 970 WFLA.
Excuse me, Brian. Thank God you're here. Now, when are you going to take some of J. Core's money and go out there and investigate the lap dancing? I mean, seriously, let's get on
lap dance research. I'll do that for you.
Let's get on to hard issues. For God's sake, let's on with the old and on with the new.
I agree.
I hear your voice. I love it.
We need some real news in this damn organization.
What a man. You're the greatest guy in the world.
Take care, sir. Appreciate it. 970 WFLA.
Hey, how you doing? It's Brian there.
Yeah, this is Brian. Go ahead.
Brian, how you doing?
Good.
What are we going to do about the monkey women if you're on this morning?
What do you mean? The only reason I'm here right now is because they yanked Bob Lasseter off the air. I'm not here of my own free will by any stretch.
What
I happen
about
to be
the monkey women.
I happen to be a innocent bystander sucked into a terrible vacuum this morning, and I'm not a happy man.
Brian, we want the monkey women.
All right, I'll get them for you this afternoon. 970 WFLA.
Lasseter blows.
Well. 970 WFLA.
Hi, Brian.
Yes.
I called earlier this week and spoke with Bob, and we didn't agree politically, but, you know, he was a riot. He just cracked me up.
Mm-hmm.
I just loved it. I can't believe he's off. I was gone. I'm at work now, and I was gone when this all happened. I'm dying to know what had happened.
Well, I can let you in on the fact that all I simply did was walked in the door, had an appointment with a client at noon, and was going down the hallway. There were management types wandering the hallways, and
Looking nervous?
Yes, and Sue Trikas basically grabbed me. As Bob Lasseter was being escorted out the door, she said, get in there behind the microphone and take care of the last few minutes of the program, and I'm like, totally oblivious to what's going on, but I appreciate the call.
Well, I think he's great.
All right, thank you. All right. Well, we'll know more about what's going on. Maybe we'll have some more information for you on my show this afternoon at 4 o'clock. Until then, have a pleasant day. We'll talk to you later.
About 27 minutes away from the hour of 8 o'clock. Did you ever wonder why we go out and we do outside promotions? Did you ever wonder about that? Well, the fact of the matter is, the truth of the matter is, there are really any number of reasons. But one of the reasons is so that we can remind ourselves that the people that we hear from and the people that really comprise the audience are not one and the same. Because the people that we hear from are all strange, to put it mildly. So it kind of helps to go out into the real world and reassure ourselves that we're not talking to just idiots and fools and morons and jerks. And by the way, it doesn't really make any difference because there are idiots, fools, morons, and jerks on both sides of the political spectrum. It's not just the right-wingers. I mean, have you noticed that you never hear on my show a call from, for example, Carolyn from Newport Richey? Or any of the other classic liberals. Have you noticed that? There's a reason for it. It's because I've bitterly, bitterly disappointed them. I've received letters from Carolyn's son begging and pleading with me to carry the torch. I've had calls from TJ begging and pleading with me when I first came back here, was doing mornings over at SUN. I mean, it was hilarious and yet pathetic at the same time. There was poor old TJ on the phone. I'm over at SUN trying to do a morning show. And she wants me to listen to Rush Limbaugh every day and come in the following day on SUN and point by point go over what he said and correct him. This is not a battle between the forces of good and evil. It's radio. It's entertainment. Period. End of story. Well, anyway, Tuesday I came in here, and it's pretty much the same story as Monday. Wednesday I didn't do the mornings because we had the baseball game, but that didn't really help things very much because they were still inundated all day long. Where's Mark? What's this baseball crap going on? Where's Rush? What's this baseball? I'm never going to listen again. Ever. Ever. Is he going to be back tomorrow? Are you ever going to preempt Rush for the first game ever of a baseball team again? Ever? Huh? Will you? I won't listen. Thursday, same story. I come back. And Friday, I was sick as a dog. I actually thought very seriously about not coming in on Friday. When I was walking down the hall about 10 minutes to 8 to get ready to come in here, I was a little woozy. You know, the head was spinning round and round and round. But I said, no, you know, I got to drag my ass in there. And so I did, and I came in, and I sat down here Friday morning and just barely able to sit up, to tell you the truth. Look over at the phones, and there it comes all over again. Another rush of people who think they're going to engage the board operator in debate. My phones, no way. And so I sit here, and again, 3 hours, basically chat with Bob. About 20 minutes to 12, Freakus comes into the studio and says, I don't know if you want to go along with this, but Brian just came in. How about if we say that we pulled you off the air and Brian finishes the show? I said, sure. So I get up from this chair and I move one chair over. Brian sits down here. And oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy. Oh, we're enjoying the hell out of this.
I'm glad they got rid of him. I'm telling you, Brian, I like you. You're a good man, Brian. I'm telling you, this Lassiter, he is rude. I mean, have you ever heard the things that he says about people? What, is he gay or something? Is he gay, Brian?
No, he's not gay. I know his wife.
What, does she get dog face with hair all over it? He's rude, man.
Guy doesn't even realize that he is doing what he's accusing me of doing. Has no idea.
I'm telling you, have you heard the people that have been calling up today? Where does he get them from?
Easy. They're Larson's listeners. Okay. So now we take a break. It's 10 minutes to 12. Freakus comes back in and says, this is great. And we're laughing and slapping our thighs. And I said to Freakus, well, look, if we're going to do this, let's sell it all the way. Put somebody else in for me tonight. And she thought about it for a second and said, okay. So I took the night off. And then Hobbs says, well, how about if I put on this announcement saying that there'll be this big announcement on Monday? And that's fine with me. I have no problem with it. Like I said, we give these people all the respect that they are due. Now the morons are in a feeding frenzy. Just a feeding frenzy, thinking that they have won. I mean, here's Brian saying, well, I don't know. I saw him take him into the general manager's office.
How many did it take to get him out of the studio, Brian?
So we let them think it. And that's what happened. And it will happen again. I promise you, anytime you want it to. We're more than happy to tweak your nose. We're more than happy to rub your nose into your own mess anytime you want us to. You just let us know. You just let us know, and we'll do it for you. It's going to happen again because we firmly believe in giving morons all the respect that they are due. So now you know what really happened. But there's really a hell of a lot more to this than meets the eye. Let's go to Jim in Tampa. Jim, you're on the air at 970 WFLA.
Yeah, hi, dude. Do you have the violin tuned up? Because I don't think you're going to play me like a violin.
Uh-huh.
You ready?
Yeah.
Okay, now you're always talking about how great you are, your track record, and
probably play you like a jug,
okay,
a little closer
to
it, yeah.
Try this for
don't
size.
Really sound
we'll
like
talk
a
about your track record.
Tuned violin.
We'll talk about your track record.
Sure.
If you give me a chance.
Uh-huh.
They threw you off the air in Chicago 2.5 years ago.
No, sir.
Yes, sir.
No, sir.
Oh, yes, sir.
No, sir.
Don't tell me they didn't.
It was 4.5 years ago.
Well, whenever it was.
Yeah.
You had a lousy rating on SUN, one of the lowest in the area.
No, sir, you're wrong.
I'm right.
No, you're wrong, sir. I beat the crap out of FLA. 2554.
You're wrong.
No, I'm not wrong,
well,
sir.
I'm telling you, you're wrong.
Well, you can tell me I'm wrong, sir, yeah. But unfortunately, you never sold the books. I did.
Well,
what the hell do you think I'm sitting here for, sir? Because I beat the crap out of them.
Well, in the last 4 years, you've been unemployed for a year and a half.
Uh-huh.
I don't know how great that makes you.
Sir?
How's the violin doing, Bob?
Sir?
Yeah, go ahead.
Unemployed for a year and a half? I was out of work for a year and a half, yes.
Right.
Uh-huh.
So, what's so great? What is this magnificent crap?
What's so great is I didn't have to work.
You didn't have to work?
No.
You couldn't work. You had to beg to get that SUN job from that guy in Miami.
No, sir, I didn't beg anybody. They called me.
No, you had to beg.
No, sir, they called me.
Yeah. Well, I don't think you're playing too good a tune on me. I think you're losing this one, Bob.
Well, sir, unfortunately, you're not on the right page, you know.
I'm on the right page.
Oh, okay. So, sir, what if I did have to beg?
Well, I don't know. You're always so pompous about they hired you because you're the greatest sliced bread.
I am.
You're not.
I am.
This thing's going to fizzle out the way you fizzled out on SUN.
I didn't fizzle out on SUN, sir. I had a 3-year run. They destroyed the station.
You know, that one caller had the right idea. All you do is voice problems, and you have no solutions.
Uh-huh.
And this is going to fizzle out. People are going to get tired of this act.
No, sir, they've been listening to this act for going on 11 years
now.
Yeah,
well, yeah. You and that voice of yours with the up and down.
God,
and
isn't it great? Don't you wish you had a voice like this?
It stinks.
No, it doesn't stink, sir. Your voice
ear.
Stinks. Oh, give me a break. Your voice grates on the ear. God, how obnoxious it is.
It's just good for commercials.
Uh-huh. Well, that's more than your voice is good for.
You sound like you have a note on your vocal cords.
Uh-huh.
How's the violin doing, Bob? Not too good.
No, sir, we're playing the jug, remember?
Yeah. Listen, you didn't give the time and the day of the week.
Uh-huh.
You going to give that?
I always do, sir.
Right. I don't
you know that because you listen
that.
Every day.
Are you afraid?
If I'm on twice a day, you listen twice a day.
Are you afraid they're going to repeat some programs and you have to have the date and the time on there? You don't trust the organization?
Sir, I don't know what the hell you're talking about.
Why do you give the time all the time and the date of the week?
Because that's what you do in radio, sir.
You're the only one that does that.
Well, maybe I'm the only one that practices properly.
Well, I think you didn't play me like a violin, Bob.
And that's because you're not a violin, sir. You're a jug, and I played you like it. 990 WFLA in Hillsboro, 461 WFLA in Pinellas. Let's go to Chrissy in Clearwater. Hi, Chrissy. You're on the air at 970 WFLA.
Hey, Mr. Lassiter.
Hey, Miss Chrissy.
What's your numbers going to look like if the phone lines don't light up? What happens if everyone just gets tired of it and doesn't call in?
Oh, I'm not in the least bit worried about that, Chrissy, and you shouldn't worry about it either, honey.
Doesn't that make your ratings suck?
No, Chrissy, it doesn't. No, ratings are not phone calls.
Maybe everybody should just stop calling you.
Maybe they should. Maybe you shouldn't have called, Chrissy.
Well, I figured out.
Except you couldn't resist, honey.
I'm not one of your whiny cousins from New Jersey that calls to kiss your ass.
I don't have any whiny cousins from New Jersey, sweetheart.
All the ones that are calling in. Oh, Bob, I love you. Whining. They're all from New Jersey.
No, Chrissy, the vast majority. Chrissy, the vast majority of people who call in don't kiss my ass.
They're all your cousins. You got him.
The vast majority of people, Chrissy, are kind of like you.
That last guy gave you goosebumps. He gave you goosebumps. Get over it. You're not that great.
You're not giving me goosebumps, Chrissy.
We want our cappuccino back. That's what we want.
Oh, you're not going to get it, Chrissy.
Dave Bob's going to bring back a cappuccino. That's what we want. We want a topic. We want to call in. We want somebody to laugh with. Not somebody who keeps using asshole. Who wants to hear that crap?
Chrissy, I talked for an hour and 15 minutes at the beginning of the show.
We listen to FLA. We don't.
It's not my fault if you couldn't follow it, sweetheart.
Lassiter is the whiny homo here. Not anybody else.
It's the whiny homo.
Oh, whine it, baby, for me, whine it.
Oh, Chrissy, don't you worry. I've been whining it for you every night,
just
sweetheart.
Don't anybody call in anymore.
Yeah.
You'll see your ratings. You'll see your ratings go right down the toilet. Johnny Cappuccino will be back sitting like a fat cat, and you'll be off work again for another year and a half.
Oh, Chrissy, you're on drugs again, aren't you?
Yeah. I like to see that wrestling match, you and that guy.
Really?
I like to see Valrico Bob come in and kick you. Bada boom, man.
Well, I'll bet
Johnny
you would,
Cappuccino,
Chrissy.
Man. He rules. Yeah. Bada boom.
9:52 the time. Let's go to Steve on his cell phone. Hi, Steve. You're on the air 970 WFLA.
Bob.
Yes, Steve.
When you got calling in complaining that they want Johnny Cafe Latte back on the air.
That was his wife.
It's amazing to me that people that can't call you and that they have to call and complain. When you call you, it's put your brains on the table, get ready for a decent discussion, because this man's going to pick you apart if you don't cover your bases. And that's the reason I enjoy listening to you. You get these calls of people who are just not ready for what they're about to get, and you teach them. Look, if you're not ready,
you're right. They really should. They should practice with lesser talk show hosts before they attempt this show.
That's their more cup of tea. And you know, if you're not ready to step to the plate with Bob Lasseter, get off the infield, go away, because that's definitely what it's going to make you feel like.
Well, thank you, dude.
I watched you switch from the morning in the afternoon. I drive all day, and now you're at night, and I'm just happened to be out, and I'm glad I picked you up. And best of luck, because I know you're going to knock them dead, because even though they don't want to listen, what did he know? He know you did the date and time, so that shows you how long a listener he is.
That's right.
Thank you, Bob.
Hey, thank you, man. Be good. Let's do Rivera in Tampa. Hi there, Rivera. You're on the air 970 WFLA.
Hello, asshole.
Yeah?
You never liked Dick Norman. You hated him, didn't you?
Danny. Very foolish thing that you're doing. Very foolish thing that you're doing. No, it was Danny. Danny the Dodger. Desperate, pathetic character. Let's do Chris and Tampa. Chris, you're on the air at 970 WFLA.
Bob.
Yes.
How are you doing tonight?
Excellent.
Good. I'm neither on your side nor against it. I enjoy listening to everybody calling in.
Uh-huh.
But I'm concerned.
Yeah, about what?
Well, you know, about the advertising.
You're concerned about the advertising?
Yeah,
uh-huh.
I'm concerned that maybe you don't believe in the products and you're just sort of choking it out.
Uh-huh.
Now, you just, about 10 minutes ago, you plugged a positive good bookstore or something.
Uh-huh.
Well, that's like Dr. Kevorkian teaching the Heimlich maneuver.
Yeah.
Don't you think? I'm concerned because I want to keep listening to you, whether I agree with you or not.
No, you're not concerned.
You're enjoyable.
No, sir, you despise me. You hope that I will die and rot in the gutter.
I don't. I'm not the guy who will call you up and go, oh, you're a jerk and an asshole or whatever like that.
Uh-huh. No, that's because you think that you're more clever than that. Unfortunately, you're not.
I don't think I'm clever, Bob.
Well, that's good, because nobody else does either.
Pardon?
I said that's good because nobody else does either.
Well, how do you know what they think?
Sir.
What?
I am the Magnificent Lasseter. 990 WFLA in Hillsborough, Pinellas 461 WFLA. Let's go to Tim on a payphone. Tim, you're on the air at 970 WFLA.
Hello, Lasseter.
Yes, Tim.
This is Tim calling. I was listening to your show tonight. You had some pretty good points. So I'd like to say two things, though. Number one, it really astonishes me, and it doesn't surprise me that no one can give you a call and explain to you why Satan does exist. And it's really it really tells you where our people are today who are Christians who say they love the Lord when they have no clue even how to explain it to you. Let me ask you a question, okay? You there?
Yeah, I'll be here till 10.
Okay, let me ask you a question. Do you believe in Jesus?
No, sir.
No, sir?
No, sir.
You don't believe he existed?
I've already answered you.
Okay, what about... All right. Most people who are even in your... who believe that Satan does not exist or believe that there wasn't a God, believe in Jesus. Most people do. Because Jesus has been recorded throughout time. I mean, if you even look in the history books...
Which history books, sir?
There is a Jesus,
which
okay?
history books, sir?
What?
Which history books?
Even the secular history books.
No, I'm sorry, sir. There is one mention of Jesus in Josephus. It is an obvious forgery. It is considered to be a forgery. It comes in the middle of something else. There's nothing before it, nothing after it makes any sense. There's no historical mention in history books of Jesus, sir.
You don't believe in Jesus whatsoever. Whatsoever. You do not believe in him. I mean, you don't even believe he was a person who existed?
You've
got to give me that benefit of the doubt.
No, I don't have to give you any benefit of the doubt. There is no historical reference whatsoever outside of a self-serving book called the Bible.
Let me ask you. Now, there is.
There isn't, sir.
In the Book of Mormon, in the Book of the Quran, the Muhammad.
Sir, the Book of Mormon is not a historical book. The Quran is not a historical book.
The Muslims, and you ask if the Quran is an historical book. You even look in the Satanic Bible, and Jesus exists.
Okay. Sir, the only people that believe in Satan are people that believe in Christianity.
No.
I'm sorry, sir. It's the only point of reference for the devil, for God's sake.
I still don't believe you say that you do not believe that Jesus ever walked this earth, even as a man, 100% man, or what have you. I mean, that fathoms me to hear someone, someone of your intelligence say that Jesus never existed. I mean, I've been speaking with people, atheists, I've been speaking with people who are well-educated in this verse, in this manner, and they all say Jesus exists. Whether he's the Son of God or not is yet to be determined. Okay, but let's just say if Jesus existed, all right? Let's just say that there was a man called Jesus. Do you believe he was a good man, or do you believe he was a lunatic?
Why don't we talk about Bugs Bunny?
What?
Why don't you ask me if I think that Bugs Bunny, if he existed, was good or bad?
Well, Bugs Bunny existed.
There is no reason for me to believe that a historical character named Jesus of Nazareth, whether the Son of God or not, ever existed. There is no reason for me to believe that he did.
No reason for you to. If you look in the history books, I'm talking about the original history books.
Sir, there are no original history books, for God's sake.
I'm not talking about the history books that were written in America. I'm talking about the original history.
Sir, there are no original history books.
Let me ask you a question then. Where does B.C. and A.D. come from? B.C. is before Christ, A.D. is in the year of our Lord. Why in the world does everyone believe in A.D. and B.C.?
Sir?
The whole world believes in it.
No, they don't.
Yes, they do.
Sir, there are large portions of the world that have a different calendar.
What are we living in?
What part of the world would you...
96 A.D. in
They are not in Beijing, China, sir.
Even the Chinese...
No, they don't, sir. They have their own goddamn calendar.
They believe in Hindu, but they believe that Jesus existed. And he died, and he did exist. As a man, he did exist.
Oh, Jesus, God.
And let me ask you a question. You go back and you look in Rome. You look in Rome when Herod had that decree of Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. Then you look at Herod trying to wipe out all the babies. Jesus did exist.
Sir.
I mean, you look
sir,
at it. And this
sir,
is
sir,
the
you
no,
look at it. There is
the
no other
Lassiter.
Reference
yes,
to that except in the Bible,
you.
Sir.
Lassiter.
Yeah, I know. Read the original history
Lassiter
books that don't exist.
It is recorded in Israel's history that there was a king called Herod and that there was a man called Jesus.
Sir, there
Herod
well may have been
way.
A king called
you
Herod, sir.
Pilate.
That does not prove that there was a Jesus.
No, you look at Pilate and you look at the crucifixion.
Sir, did you ever hear the Great Gatsby?
No, can I ask you a question?
Did you ever hear the Great Gatsby? Well, you know, if you read the Great Gatsby, there's talk about Little Egg Harbor and Big Egg Harbor.
Yes.
They actually exist.
Okay.
Does that mean the Great Gatsby existed?
No.
That's right, sir. Let's go to Scott on the Starline. Scott, you're on the air at 970 WFLA.
Mr. Lassiter, we don't like...
I'm sorry, Scott, you do an incredibly poor interpretation of whatever the hell it is that you're trying to do. I suggest that you work some of the lesser shows on this station or others. That's your choice until you're really qualified to be on our show. We don't find fictitious, affected Negro accents to be amusing here. I believe that they are considered to be very amusing on the Mark Larson show, especially if you can do it with kind of a suggestion of homosexuality. Okay, I've been back now about 3 months back on this station, and in some respects, nothing much has changed. It's a lot like it was when I was here before, internally and externally, and yet at the same time, man, a lot has changed. I mean, a lot. The biggest change seems to be in the audience. Audience is still very large. The audience is still very responsive. Well, actually, I should say the biggest change is in the callers, to be more specific. A lot of them, not all of them by any stretch of the imagination, but a lot of them are much bolder than they were 5, 6, 7 years ago when I was here. A lot of them are a hell of a lot more at ease than lashing out and venting their anger and their rage, which basically comes down to attacking and belittling other groups of people. It's not that it didn't happen before. It did. It just happens now with much, much, much more regularity. In short, a lot of the callers are pretty damned ugly. Incredibly ugly, which is one of the things that, of course, makes me sit back and smile when I'm told that I'm not nice enough. What, I'm not nice enough because I don't bash gays? I'm not nice enough because I don't constantly belittle, minorities? That would somehow make me nicer? Well, it seems as though a lot of the callers need to slander other people, that they, you know, presumably to bolster their own deficiencies. That's usually why people belittle other people, is to make themselves feel bigger, to make themselves feel more important, to make themselves feel better. An example, by the way, would be the constant references to homosexuality on this station. I mean constant references. With at least a certain segment of the audience bashing, trashing anybody that they disagree with. Anybody they disagree with is charged as being gay or lesbian or whatever it turns out to be. Now, I ain't no shrink, but I do find this to be kind of interesting. Very interesting, to tell you the truth. And I can't really say for sure what it means, but I do have my suspicions. I mean, we have this slew of callers who relish going on the air and mocking gays. I mean, hell, we have a host who actually schedules a day for it, where he and any number of his callers sit there for hours on end ridiculing the faggy boys for no apparent reason at all, other than the fact that they seem to enjoy it. I find it deeply offensive. I find it kind of sick, and I don't mind telling you that. And on this show, hardly a day goes by without some hotshot barging in on the conversation to charge me with being a faggot, a fudge packer, or some other crude reference. It is done, I presume, to embarrass me, to humiliate me. It's done to make me stop saying the things that I say that they don't want to hear. It's done to kind of herd me in the right direction, but it doesn't work. I mean, more often than not, have you noticed more often than not the people that do that tend to be the younger males? That's where it kind of gets interesting. The younger males who are apparently still unsure of their own sexuality, and at the same time, they're obsessed with it. The young studs. It's not easy being a young male. I remember it very well. It's a very difficult time in life, because you're never really quite sure when you stop being a boy and when you start being a man. It's an impossible question to ask. It's an impossible question to answer. And it's a very unpleasant point in a male's life. Nobody really takes you seriously. It's hard to determine whether you're the man that you want to be or still the boy that you have been all of your life. It's an uncomfortable period. You don't really have any power. You don't have any influence. You don't have any place in the older male-dominated society. I remember it very well. You want very much to be like the older males, and so you try to emulate them, which is almost impossible. And then, if you're really unlucky, you live in Tampa, Florida, and you turn on the radio and you encounter someone like me. I have all the trappings of the older dominant male, and yet I don't behave like him. Not even close. It must be very confusing to these poor young studs. Can't understand it. They're unable to deal with it. Unable to understand how it is possible. Unable to cope with it. So what do? They attack. Anonymously on the telephone. Kind of like reminds you of turning on PBS and there's some kind of show on there with lions in Africa, and there's the poor, young, immature male hiding in the bushes waiting for the gazelle to go by. And after the gazelle has gone by, he jumps out from behind the bushes and goes, "Roar, roar." It's not easy being a male, is it? Nope. But I have a lot more to say about this. As a matter of fact, I would strongly suggest you stay right where you are, because by the time I'm finished saying what I have to say, if you didn't like me before, you're really going to dislike me tonight. I promise you that much. And I always keep my promises to you. I always keep my promises to you. You're going to be deeply offended. And I don't give a crap. I never really talk about on the air, because I don't talk about off the air, the man-woman thing, the men are from Mars, women are from Venus, kind of stuff. It just, frankly, has no particular interest to me, and so I don't really ever talk about it. But it's not easy being a male. It's not easy being a man. There are a lot of things that you feel you should be able to do, a lot of things that you feel are your birthright, that just never work out. They're always just out of your reach. But everything that you've been taught when you were growing up, everything that you've heard, everything that you've read about, everything that you've seen, it just doesn't ever really seem to work out that way for most males. An example would be the drive, this inbred drive to be the provider, to be the head of the family, the one who brings home the kill for your family to feast on, the one that the family gathers around for protection from the evil forces out there. The one who has all the answers in a question and a world filled with questions that don't have answers. The one to look up to. The head of the family. Doesn't work out that way for most males. Most men will never experience those sensations. And yet they're inbred. Most men will never experience the sensation of being in control of their own destiny. Because other more powerful males won't let them do it. And there's nothing they can do about it. They just have to eat it. Most men go through life feeling basically unfulfilled. Never once really experiencing what they presume being a male is all about. Being in control. It's frustrating and it hurts. It hurts to admit that you're but a pawn, that you and your life are at the whim and mercy of some other more dominant male. Often one that you can't even see. Often one that, hell, you don't even know his name. One that you can't challenge, one that you can't reason with, one that you can't overthrow. But the pathetically powerless loser is so damned impotent that all he can do is to belittle the people that he thinks are weaker than he is. We run into these kinds of people all day, every day, everywhere you go. And for some strange reason, a lot of them have migrated to talk radio as callers. Where they feel safe lashing out, venting their anger, their frustration, attacking the weaker people. Hiding behind the telephone. Gathering in large packs to hunt down the weaker prey. So who the hell are the weaker prey? Good question. I think you know. Oh, to faggots and to darkies and to Jew boys and the outspoken females. Almost anyone will do so long as they're perceived as being weaker. So long as this pack of impotent young males and the pathetic older males think that it's safe to attack them. Did you ever notice, for example, how my sexuality is a very common topic of conversation on this radio station? But you know what? None of these pathetic characters really care about who or how I make whoopee. But by raising the issue, they foolishly think that they will put me in my place, so to speak. That by raising the issue, they will somehow silence me, keep me from saying things that they don't want to hear. You see, they don't understand I am a dominant male. I'm the one who has a little bit of power. I'm one who has some control over my own life. I'm one who has tasted what they will never taste. So the cowardly, powerless males gather in packs and they hide behind the telephone to attack in the only way available to them. It's all right, I understand. To tell you the truth, I'm rather amused by it. In fact, sometimes I actually forget that I'm one of the dominant males, and the poor fools actually help to remind me. Especially when the lesser males get their women to make the calls for them. And you can hear them standing in the background telling the girls what to say. That one amuses me to no end. It's like they think that if a female leads the attack, it somehow legitimizes it. Again, the poor souls don't realize that the lesser females tend to mate with the lesser males. And so it doesn't really impress anyone. I can't conceive.
Muffy, you call that Larson and you tell him blah, 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 blah.
I can't conceive of a situation like that. And I can't conceive of one of the better women being put into a situation like that. So just in case you didn't understand what's really going on, now you do. And here's the kicker. Here's the kicker. Even after being exposed for what they are, the lesser males are still going to hide behind their telephones and prove beyond a doubt that everything I just said is gospel. Let's go to Farah. Farah, you're on the air at 970 WFLA.
I just wanted to tell you, I'm not a coward.
Uh-huh.
And I would like to say, I've listened to you off and on for 26 years, and I think you're the most boring person I have ever listened to in the time I've lived here.
Well, thank you, Farah.
And
that's what I'm here for, is to drive people like you away.
Oh, well, you have.
Yes, I can tell that.
Nobody's
26 years. Sit
from 7 till 10 listening to that boring stuff of yours.
Mm-hmm.
And by the way, that little squeaky toy you was talking about, your wife brought you, you told that every station you've ever been on.
And I guess you've listened to me at every station I've ever been on, huh, Fire?
Off and on.
Oh, off and on, yeah. Yeah.
But,
by accident.
We certainly turned you off now, and for them to put you on and take off
Sarah,
Johnny, I can't
Sarah,
believe
if you,
it.
If you've turned me off, how did you know I was on tonight?
Because I had James on, and we hadn't turned it off yet.
Oh, an hour and 14 minutes later. What, do you move a little slower now that you're so elderly?
Sir, I didn't get that.
I'm sorry, I forgot your advanced years. Do you move a little slower now that you're so old?
Well, I don't doubt that I'm as old as you are. I doubt it very seriously.
Uh-huh.
Because you've been on the circuit a long time.
It's 26 like years, yeah.
Men said you get kicked off everywhere you go, and if they keep you there, they're going to lose lots of listeners.
Like you, yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you. Let's go to Beverly. Beverly, you're on the air 970 WFLA.
Hello?
Yes, hello.
Bob Lassiter?
Yes.
Oh, I just wanted to tell you that I'm new from New York. I've been here 2 years, but I just discovered you. And I'll tell you something. I used to listen to ABC, and all the nice, angry people were so great. And I'm so delighted to meet you and hear you talking very angrily.
Well, thank you, Beverly.
So, thanks a lot. I'll call again.
Your friend in the background seems to be rather fascinated hearing you on the radio.
Yes, he is, because he's listening to the radio.
Hello, Radio Land.
He says, hello, Radio Land. Listen, I think it's great. Keep up the good work.
Oh, I'll be happy to.
I want to hear you talk about anger about the unemployment situation and all about, you know, big deals. Yeah, I don't know whether you ever had people from ABC come down here. Did you ever have Bob Grant on?
Did I ever have Bob Grant on?
Did ABC ever have Bob Grant down here?
ABC isn't down here, ma'am.
Oh, what is FLA?
What do you mean, what is FLA? It's a radio station.
What network is it?
It's owned by J-Corp, ma'am.
Oh, I see. It's not the same as ABC.
No, it's not the same as ABC.
But it's good. Oh, it's good. And I'm so glad you're there. And listen,
I sound better than Bob Grant.
Yeah, you sound better than Bob Grant. Okay?
Okay.
Okay, thanks a lot.
Take care.
You too. Bye-bye.
I also don't run out on lunch checks like Bob Grant does. Let's go to James on the Starline. James, you're on the air at 970 WFLA.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening, James.
I just happened to get in my truck. First time I've heard you. I had it on Rush Limbaugh, and I got out of it, got back in and turned it on. It's on the same station. But if I'll say one thing. If you're the measure of a dominant male, there's a lot of us that may not want to be, and a lot of women that probably don't want to be associated with one.
Really? Why is that, sir?
Well, it's your viewpoint.
Well, what's my viewpoint?
Well, from what I've heard so far, not very acceptable to me. You know?
Well, what if I said that's not acceptable to you?
Well, you're just putting everybody down, and in the first place, that's not...
Oh, no, sir. I invited guys like you to call up and put everybody down.
No, I'm not putting anybody down. The only thing I'm saying is...
Well, you're trying to put me down. You didn't even listen to what I said.
I heard the first part of your show where you're talking about you were a dominant male and all this kind of
thing. Well, I am.
And I listened to more, and you're just nasty to people. And if you're what a dominant male should be, then I'm sorry, but I don't want to be in your category.
I'm nasty to people, sir? Why would you say that?
Oh, now, God.
What did you hear me say that was nasty?
Huh?
What did you hear me say that was nasty?
You're just rude.
Well, except for the fact that I said I was here to make, you know, angry white males miserable. Outside of that, I didn't say anything nasty.
Yeah, you're quite rude, and you do that. But it gets you a lot of attention, and people call because they won't argue with you. But I'm not really going to argue with you because I've already turned my radio off. Since I'm off the air, I won't listen to you anymore.
Oh, you turned your radio off. You're just calling.
No, I turned it off since I got you on the speaker because I didn't want the beep.
Uh-huh.
But, no, I don't think you anywhere near represent a dominant male. And
Well, then tell me what does. Well, tell me how I could mend my ways.
Male dominates without being domineering.
Uh-huh.
They're more of a leader than what you are.
It's amazing. It's amazing. You've listened to me for how long now?
Well, just a few minutes.
Just a few minutes. You know so much about me. My God.
But,
have you ever considered opening up a fortune-telling service or something like that, maybe?
I thought about it. If you want to call back on my psychic line, I'll give you my number.
Uh-huh.
But, no, it didn't take you long to tell right quick what you are.
What am I?
Well, you're just not what most people would want to be.
Well, just tell me what I am.
I don't have to. I think everybody out here listening knows.
Tell me what I am, sir.
Huh?
Tell me what I am.
What are you?
Yeah.
Well, you're certainly not representative of the mainstream.
Yeah.
Now, you're entitled to your viewpoint. You're entitled to espouse it. And, you know, everybody, I guess the thing
is... So let me see. I'm opposed to exploiting minorities, and that makes me not representative of the mainstream.
No, I didn't say anything about minorities. You brought
I did.
Huh?
I did.
If you're exploiting... I think you're exploiting the
mainstream, sir.
By trying to... you're exploiting them worse than anyone else.
Uh-huh.
Because that's what keeps your audience.
Uh-huh.
And, quite frankly, most people are not anti-everything. Sure, there's some on both sides that are against anything and everybody.
Yeah.
And racist doesn't come by any particular color. There's white, black, green, yellow, and everything else racist.
Really?
You know, so...
Did I say there weren't?
No, I didn't say...
No, I didn't.
You said there was.
Right.
But, people are going to be people. You can't make them believe anything particular.
I'm not here to make anybody believe anything different, sir.
But you're not...
I didn't tell you what to believe, did I?
You're not going to influence me, and...
Didn't say I was here to influence you, sir, did I?
No, but if you're what you're representing a dominant male to be...
I am a dominant male, sir.
Well...
there's no denying that.
Well, it may be in your view, but maybe not in other people's view.
Uh-huh.
So... All right, I gotta go in the store. So, enjoy talking with you.
I don't think so, sir. In Tampa, Den, you're on the air 970 WFLA.
Hello?
Yes, hello.
Okay, I'd like to ask you, how do you regard religion?
What do you mean, how do I regard religion?
It's an institution. How do you regard it?
I don't know what
you're talking
about.
It's the most important of all our institutions.
And?
Let me ask you, truth, do you feel it exists?
What are you doing?
The truth of gravity, when you have a hammer and you drop it, it hits the ground. That's
well, it all depends on where you're standing. If you're standing, on a planet X, it might not. It might fall up.
Gravity will naturally go to the largest masses. Yes, of course.
Yes.
But gravity is a truth. It does exist.
Well, no, it's a relative truth. It depends on where you're talking about gravity existing.
It's absolute. It depends on masses.
No, it is not universal. There are planets where you could drop your hammer and it would fall up.
According to Einstein, this is only driven by mass.
Yes, and unfortunately, his laboratory was the Earth. He did not have the benefit of working in other laboratories.
Too. But the point is that it always driven to the greatest mass.
So what the hell's the point?
So therefore, truth does exist. Is that right?
If you say so, what is your point?
My point is that if we say the truth does exist, then... the opposite, a lie, does not exist. Is that true?
Oh, darn. Call was accidentally terminated. I'm not here to debate abortion with you. Oh, I stopped doing that years ago. Nor am I here to bait you. But that's the question I would ask you. How in the hell can you associate with people who don't see it as murder, let alone vote for one or belong to a party that welcomes one? That's my question. Explain this to me, please. I mean, there must be an explanation, wouldn't you think? There has to be an explanation for this. One that I'm just overlooking. For how you can be so convinced that innocent people are being murdered and butchered left and right, and yet you don't really want to do much about it, except maybe pass a constitutional amendment or something. Otherwise, it looks like a lot of you are saying things that you don't really believe. And I think it's an important question because we have a presidential candidate. We have a political party that says, oh, bad, murder, 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 kill, kill, murder, kill.
But if you want to join anyway, that's okay with us. And we don't really want to do anything about it anyhow, except maybe pass a constitutional amendment.
Let's do Bruce on the Star Line. Bruce, you're on the air at 970 WFLA.
Hello, Mr. Lassiter.
Yes, Bruce.
To answer the first half of your question, do I think it's murder? Yes, I do.
No, sir, I didn't ask you if you did. I wasn't asking you to call up and tell me whether you did. I was asking you to call up only if you do.
Okay, sir. Mm-hmm. I do think it's murder. As to whether or not I would do anything about it, currently, no, because of the present laws.
Wasn't the question, sir. Do you want it to be a capital offense?
Yes.
Okay, Dr. N. Woman.
Definitely on the doctor, probably on the woman, depending on her mental state. Wait a second, sir.
If you brought someone to a murderer, knowing full well that they were going to be murdered, you would be an accessory to the crime.
Yeah, without a doubt.
So then the woman should be, too. She should also face capital charges.
Yes, she would be.
Okay, excellent. Thank you so much.
Yep.
Let's go to Betty in Pinellas Park. Betty, you're on the air at 970 WFLA.
Yes, I do think it's murder, and I say yes on the other question. And I can't understand why people have to beat around the bush. Why don't they just say yes or no and get it over with?
Well, it took you 2 hours, Betty.
No, it didn't take me. I just came in the house and heard you, and that's why I called.
Fry them both.
I have been out.
Fry them both.
Yes.
Make